So for the first minute, or just our warm-up minute, we're going to take some knee circles, but we're going to do like an alternating pattern. So we're going to circle it out, circle it in, and then set it down, switch to the other leg. Switch, circle it out, circle it in, switch to the other leg, circle it out, or use whatever pattern you like, but we're just going one way and then the other with one leg, and then one way and the other with the other leg. And we just want to kind of tune in. How is your hips feeling this morning? How do your knees feel? How is your balance? Did you get enough sleep last night? How do your feet feel about this work? Nice work. We got 20 seconds left. So for our rounds this morning, the first two sets will be just a slow pace with heavy weights if you can. And then the third round, you'll choose whether or not you want to use your weights and go for speed, or set the weights down and go for speed, or set the weights down and go slow. Okay, that's time. Now, for the next minute, we are going to flick our fingers. So fingers to the insides of the thumbs. That's the first bit of work. So find that first. Okay, now turn your toes in towards each other and take it into a little pigeon-toed walk, but keep flicking your fingers. So soften the knees, walk yourself around with your toes turned in towards each other. Make sure your knees are soft so that your knees don't feel cranky about this work, but keep flicking the fingers. That's where the real action's happening. All right, one more moment with that pigeon-toed walk, and now take it into a tippy-toe walk. So now toes and knees pointing forward. Lift your heels, keep flicking your fingers. That's where the real work's happening. Notice if you're losing a little stamina in your hands, it might be getting a little bit fatigued at this point. We got 8 seconds left. Woo, and time. Okay, give your wrists and your fingers a little shake. Set your heels down. And now fingertips to the shoulders. And we're just going to take the elbows in some nice, generous circles. Go in one direction. Awesome. Keep your fingers on your shoulders. Take your elbows and circle them the other way. And then notice how your shoulders are feeling here. You might go with smaller circles. It might be super small and gentle. But if everything's feeling good, 5 more seconds. And now see if you can take your hands behind your head, head into the hands, hands into the head. Bend your knees, hinge from your waist. Come to a halfway fold. Keep pressing your head into your hands, rise back up. Bend your knees, hinge from your waist. Take your heart forward, head presses into the hands. And then nice and strong, lift yourself back up. Beautiful, keep that going. Keep a nice moderate pace. Beautiful, now the next time you rise up, keep your hands behind your heads and just take a couple of side bends just to take that spinal movement into the other direction. Nice, one more bend each side. And then as you come back to center, release your hands, shrug out your shoulders, notice how everything's feeling. And now grab a nice heavy set of weights. The first movement is gonna be a wide stance. So we're gonna step our feet super wide. We're gonna load up at the shoulders and we're gonna start with some knee bends. So we're just gonna bend out to the side. Notice here how your knees feel and you'll want to rearrange your legs. You'll wanna rearrange the rotation of your leg so that your knees feel good about this work. If you want that extra bit of effort up in the upper body, you're going to keep your weights lifted off your shoulders so the arms stay engaged. Nice. Nice and slow and steady here. Take your time. On the third round of this, you might go for some speed, but for now, take it slow. You're already halfway there. Nice work. We got 10 seconds left. And time. Awesome job. Okay. Step it in, lower your weights down. Now we're going to take it into some squats. So if you need to set your weights down, do it. Load up at the shoulders, feet about hip width distance apart. And now we're going to think butt back, bend your knees. So you're just going to sit back into your squat, come up nice and strong. If you're noticing that your legs need a little bit of extra care today, set the weights down, do the work unloaded. But if it feels good to keep it loaded, keep your chest and chin slightly lifted. Nice. And then as you're doing your work here, just check in with your knees and your inner thighs. So if your knees are buckling in or sickling out, just make sure you keep your inner thighs engaged. Beautiful. Already halfway there. Ten seconds left. And time. Awesome job. Okay, now we're going to take it into deadlifts. So we're going to let the weights hang down in front of the body, palms facing inward, feet about hip distance apart. And now we're going to hinge from the waist. So we're going to keep a subtle bend in the knees just so that we don't pull against the hamstrings. Squeeze those glutes as you come back up. We got 1 minute on the clock. This is a slow and steady round. So even pace going down and an even pace coming up. Squeeze those glutes as you rise up. If you find that you're struggling to keep your head and neck in line, tuck your chin slightly, focus on that chin tuck, and then focus on the squeeze of the glutes as you come up. Nice job, you guys. Beautiful. 10 seconds left. And time. Awesome work. Okay. Set the weights down if you need to. Grab a sip of water if you need to. But then we're going to repeat that set. So we're going to load up at the shoulders, step it out to that wide position. And now we're going to add on if you like. So rather than keeping the weights loaded up at the shoulders, you can reach down, frame the foot as you come back up, hug it up to the shoulders, take it over to the other side, touch down. This is still one of our slow rounds. So slow and steady, a nice even pace. We're using those really big muscle groups. So just make sure that everything is lined up so there's no shooting pain in the knees. Hips are feeling good about that movement. You can always make it smaller or arrange it to work in your body. You're already halfway there. Nice work. Five seconds left. And time. Beautiful job. Okay, step your legs in. We're taking it right back to our squats. So now choose a different variation if you like. Maybe a little bit wider. Load up at the chest. Butt back. Bend your knees. Rise back up. We keep the chest and chin lifted for this one. So it's an upright torso. And we're working in our glutes. Mostly quadriceps and glutes for this bit of work for our squats, slightly different from our deadlifts. So just make sure you're keeping that upright position with your chest. Nice. If you want a little add-on here, maybe you add a little bicep curl or an overhead press, any bit of work that you think might be good for you this morning. 10 seconds left. You got this. And time. Awesome job. Okay, we're back to our deadlifts. So step your feet in, back to that hip width distance, toes and knees pointing forward, arms down in front, a little bend in the knees, hinge from your hips, lean forward, come back up, squeeze your glutes. 1 minute on the clock, slow and steady here. You're already halfway there. Nice work. And time. Awesome job. Okay, last round here. So this is going to be our round for speed if you want. I'm going to set my weights down. You choose your own adventure. If you like using your weights, keep them, but come back to that wide stance. And now we're going to go a little bit faster. But if speed's not for you, you're going to keep it slow and steady. If you want that speed round, now you're going to start to just pick up the pace, touch to the inside of the foot, take it right over to the other side. Keep a nice sense of fluid movement here, but you're still strong in your legs. So just make sure that you're going at a pace that works good for you and your knees feel happy about this position. You can always rearrange anything that you need to or slow it down. Nice, you guys, beautiful. Twenty seconds left. And time. Awesome job. Okay, step your legs in. We're moving right into our squats and we're going for speed. Butt back, bend your knees, rise back up. Take it at a nice pace that works good for you. Catch a good rhythm, equal pace going up as going down, and then load up if you want to, or leave the weights off so you can just really focus on finding that nice faster pace. Nice. Twenty seconds left. And time. Woo, great job. Okay, last one for this set into our deadlifts. Weighted or not weighted, totally up to you, but that same rhythm. If you want to go unweighted, you might choose to just reach down, touch the ground, come up with a little bit of speed, squeeze those glutes. And even if you want to find that little squeeze, think about pushing your arms back so you feel that little bit of extension through the front of your hips. Yes, nice work. Slow it down if you need to, but if you can keep that faster pace, you got it. Get your heart rate up just a little bit. Let your breath come up a little bit. And time. Woo! Great job. Okay, shake out your legs. Grab a sip of water. We're taking it down to the ground. All right, if you've got your sip of water, take it on down to the ground. And then just have your hand weights just nearby so that you'll have access to them, because we do have a chest press and a loaded hip bridge. So if you want those weights there for that, just have them nearby so that they're handy. All right, so come down onto your back. The first round is just gonna be some crunches. So hands behind the head, we crunch up and lower back down. Slow and steady here. You wanna think about pulling your abdomen down towards the spine, lifting the chest and chin, nice. Five more seconds. And time, nice job. Okay, now we're gonna take it into a dead bug, but we're gonna load it up. So legs in that bent knee position, grab your hand weights. We're gonna load them up at the shoulders, arms straight up from the shoulders, and it's gonna be opposite hand, opposite foot. So you're gonna reach out, pull it back in, switch to the other side, pull it back in. Think about pulling your abdominal muscles towards your spine to keep your back connected to the floor. As you extend out, everything else is going to try and stay as stationary as it can. So it's the left arm, right arm extending out, the other arm and leg are staying stable. Yes, you guys, nice work, beautiful. Oh my God, you guys look awesome, great job. And time, nicely done. Okay, set your feet down and now we're gonna take it into our hip bridges. So you're gonna load your weights up at the hips and then walk your feet. So they're hip width distance apart, heels pretty close to the butt. And now we're gonna lift up and lower with control. Your hands are gonna hold the weights in place, but your butt and your hamstrings are doing most of the heavy lifting. Get that nice little squeeze in those glutes as you come up and then check your knees. If your knees are buckling out or buckling in, slow it down a little bit so you can focus on keeping a little bit of tension right at the inner thighs so the knees stay in a stable position as you lift your glutes and squeeze and as you lower down. And time, beautiful work. Okay, set those weights off to the side. We're going right back to those crunches. So if you like, you can add a little variation to your crunches, maybe take it into a full body crunch so you'll bend your knees, elbows and knees hug in, and you release it out, or you might just choose to stick with your crunches. So choose the variation that's gonna work good for you. and time. Awesome job. Okay, set those feet down. We're moving right back to our dead bugs. So arms up and straight from the chest, legs up in that tabletop position. Move right back to that alternating pattern. Arm and legs extend out. We pull it back in with control. Think about keeping your abdominal muscles pulled down towards the spine. And now if you want a little variation here, if you're bored with that dead bug, keep your arms straight up from your chest and take it into some alternating fire hydrants. So you'll keep your arms steady at your chest and you'll just swing one leg out to the side and then the other. But if you were finding better work extending the leg and arm out, stick with that. But if it feels good to kind of mix it up a little bit, maybe you add that fire hydrant. Totally up to you. Nice work, you guys. All right, that's time. Next up, we're gonna do a hip bridge, but now we'll add a chest press if you like. So if you want the chest press, you're gonna load your weights up at your chest. And as you push your hips up, push your arms up towards the ceiling, lower everything back down with control. Lift the hips, squeeze the glutes, arms stretch up and lower back down. If you don't want that chest press, you'd prefer to load up at the hips, load up at the hips. You choose the version that feels good to you right now. But find a nice steady rhythm and still check those knees. So if your knees are buckling in towards each other or dropping out, you want to keep a nice even position between the knees. And a nice even up and down. So don't let gravity take hold and let your butt just drop down to the ground. We control it going up and control going down. You got it. Nice work. And time. Awesome job. Okay, we're back to our crunches. So set those weights off to the side. If you want to add a little bit of variation into your crunches, maybe at this point you'll take it into a reverse crunch. So legs up or knees bent, totally up to you, but you might choose to just get that little hip lift. So reaching the feet up towards the sky or knees and shins up towards the sky. Or you might choose to come back to that regular crunch, hands behind the head. We contract the abdominal muscles, lift the chest and chin and lower back down. But if you like that little variation, maybe you take it into those reverse, take it at any level that feels good to you at this point. This is our last round. So if you're feeling like your abdominal muscles are feeling a little fatigued, choose the one that you can sustain. You're already halfway there. Nice work. And time. Awesome job. Woo! Stretch your arms up and overhead. Just take a nice big breath just to make sure we stretch those abdominal muscles out. And then we're back to our dead bugs. Now for this last version of dead bug, if you want a little variation, you're going to keep your legs in that upright position, stable in the legs, and then the arms are just going to take it into a fly. So you're going to open out nice and wide, keep a soft, subtle bend in the elbows, let the arms come out wide, pull them back in with control. Or you might choose to take it back to that dead bug, alternating the knees. Or if you like those fire hydrants, you might choose to go back to that. Choose any version that you liked and you can sustain for this last round. If you're doing those chest flies, just tune in for a second. Notice your belly and your low back. If it feels like your low back is arching, think about pulling your belly button towards the spine to keep the low back connected with the floor. Nice work, you guys. Beautiful. Nice form. Everybody, you guys look amazing. 5 seconds left. And time. Nicely done. Okay, last round of hip bridges. So if you want that little extra challenge, you're going to lift your hips up, keep them lifted, take your hip bridge into a march. But if you need more upper body stuff, maybe you'll choose to come back to those chest presses as you lift and lower. Or if you needed just that little extra load, you might choose to just come back to that original position, loading up your weights at your hips. So totally up to you, whichever version you choose. It's our last round. You got 1 minute on the clock. Take it at your pace. The march is challenging, but it's a lot of good work, especially think of your core as your butt all the way up to the tops of your shoulders. So that is a nice bit of work coming all the way from your glutes, the backs of your legs. You might feel it work in your center. You might feel it work in the stability in your shoulders and in the backs of your arms. Nice job. 15 seconds left. You got this. Switch it up if you need to. If the march has become too much, load it up. Yes, you guys look amazing. Nice job. We got 5 seconds left. You got this. Woo! And time. Lower your hips down. If you've got weights, set them off to the side. Pull your knees up into your chest. Give yourself a light little squeeze. Maybe rock it a little side to side. Awesome. Hold on to your right knee. Let your left leg go nice and long. Cool. Now take that right knee into a little twist. Take it over and across the body. Maybe let your right arm open out nice and wide. Take a nice big breath. Awesome. Pull that right knee back into your chest. Bring the left knee in to meet. And then hold on to your left knee. Let your right leg go nice and long. Cool, and then take it into a twist. Take that left knee over to the right across the body. Maybe let your left arm open out nice and wide. Beautiful, pull that knee back into your chest. Bring the right knee in to meet. And now we're gonna take a little rock and roll up to a seated position. So rock and roll your way up so that your legs can be out in front of you nice and long, but keep your knees slightly bent. Take a nice big breath, reach up and over and think belly up and over and then reach toward your toes. It does not matter if you touch your toes, but what we're shooting for is a little stretch, maybe to the backs of the hamstrings or to the backs of the thighs, but want to make sure that there's no zinging that comes up into your glutes. So if you feel any zinging sensation up into your glutes, bend your knees just a little bit more. Nice, take one more breath. Walk yourself on up, bend your knees, come up to a standing position, and we'll just take one last little fold before we move on to our tennis ball. So step your right leg across your left so your pinky toes are lined up, and then walk down to a depth that feels good to you. So just go as far as you feel a little bit of sensation and then pause there and take a breath. Take one more breath. Awesome, come up nice and slow, uncross your legs, take it to the other side. Step your leg across, line up your pinky toes best you can. Once you've got your legs arranged, walk yourself down to a depth that feels good to you. Nice work, come up nice and slow, step your feet off, give everything a little shake, make sure it all feels good. Be sure to drink plenty of water. You guys are amazing. grab your tennis balls, two if you've got two,